So, with a sniper head, the mass murdering individual, First Lieutenant Hunter Wilson, was an engineer serving with the Army Guard for a year and a half. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And Ambassador, thank you for your service. And it's just so inspiring to be with you. So we're grateful for what you've done for our country. And it's particularly a time for us to appreciate the success of the American military. For 20 years, they stopped terrorist attacks in our country. And so as people look back, we should appreciate the success of the American military. Very personal to me, my former National Guard unit, the 218th Mechanized Infantry of the South Carolina Army National Guard, led by General Bob Livingston, served for a year across Afghanistan, and they developed a great affection for their Afghan brothers. I was there four times, seeing firsthand the success of what they were doing. And then I'm grateful my youngest son, First Lieutenant Hunter Wilson, was an engineer serving with the Army Guard for a year in Afghanistan. So it's very personal to me, the absolute disgust I have with President Joe Biden. His shameful appeasement, surrender, and abandonment of the people of Afghanistan has led immediately to the death of 13 young Americans who at Kabul airport, even though the sniper had the mass murdering individual bomber in his sights, which could have saved the 13 lives and could have saved, indeed, hundreds of poor Afghan citizens who were murdered. But yet the Biden rules of engagement came into play and 13 young Americans died. With that, too, it's also given encouragement to what we're into now, which we did not choose, and that is a war. Dictators with rule of gun invading democracies with rule of law. We saw that on February 24th, 2022, when war criminal Putin invaded Ukraine. We saw it October 7th, when Hamas, the puppets of Iran, invaded Israel. We see it today with the threats being made against the 24 million people of Taiwan by the Chinese Communist Party. All of this, to me, goes back to the shameless, shameful decision, which I think is the most catastrophic in the history of the United States, in terms of national defense, security, and foreign policy. And there's no excuse, however they rewrite history, God bless their hearts. But then, additionally, we should always remember that America was in Afghanistan and liberated Afghanistan from Taliban terrorists because of the terrorist attacks of 9/11. Again, history should not be rewritten. What happened is Osama bin Laden was operating out of a cave in Afghanistan. And so we would, and for 20 years, indeed, our military was successful to protect. But sadly, we now, by abandoning Afghanistan, the global war on terrorism is not over. It's coming to America. The FBI has identified that we're at great risk of attack imminently today in America that could occur. And so it's just shameful what occurred. Additionally, a question I have is that when on August 26, 2021, when President Biden excused his appeasement, and right in the middle of his speech, he was explaining his advisors had said to just abandon, leave now. And then he threw in, it was not on the teleprompter, I have letters. Okay, I sent him and asked that night, I asked for copies of the letters of the advice that he received to abandon the people of Afghanistan. And it should not surprise you, about every 2 months, I send a letter to the White House asking for the letters. There are no letters. They've not been revealed. But what advice was given by his advisors on leaving the people of Afghanistan to fall off jets as the abandonment took place?
Well, I believe that our military, under the leadership of the president and the chain of command, did an admirable job in a very difficult set of circumstances to get as many people out. Some 125,000 people were brought out. So I associate myself with your praise of our military. I had the honor of serving with them in Afghanistan and in Iraq, and they have done an outstanding job for the people of the United States, for our security. With regard to what you mentioned, sir, But the letters and advice, I do not have a direct knowledge of what it is that was involved there. But the advice was to bring out as many people as possible, to reach out to as many Americans and those who had worked for us or for organizations that worked for us, to bring them out. And a huge number was brought out.
Again, thank you for your service. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Chairman, yield,
sir. Israel. We see it today with the threats being made against the 24 million people. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And Ambassador, thank you for your service. And it's just so inspiring to be with who were murdered. But yet the Biden rules of engagement, 20 years, right. They stopped terrorist attacks in our country. And so as people look back to the shameful decision, which I think is the most catastrophic in the